This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Kingdom of Galicia and Lodomeria, also known as Galicia or Austrian Poland, became a crownland of the Habsburg monarchy as a result of the first partition of Poland in 1772. When it became a kingdom under Habsburg rule from 1804 to 1918, it was a crownland of the Austrian Empire after the reforms of 1867. It became an ethnic Pole-administered autonomous unit under the Austrian crown. The country was carved from the entire southwestern part of the Polish-Lithuanian Commonwealth. Among the many ceremonial titles of the princes of Hungary was ruler of Galicia and Lodomeria. The name Galicia is the Latinized form of Halic, a principality of the medieval Ruthenia. Lodomeria is also a Latinized form of Volodymyr Volinsky that was founded in the 10th century by the Vladimir the Great and until the partitions of Poland was known simply as Volodymyr Polish. Wolodymyr's King of Galicia and Lodomeria was a medieval title that King of Hungary Andrew II adopted during his conquest of the region back in the 12th century. This historical region in Eastern Europe is divided today between Poland and Ukraine. The nucleus of historic Galicia consists of the modern Lviv, Ternopil, and Ivano-Frankivsk regions of western Ukraine. Contents: 1. Ceremonial name. 2. History. 21. From 1815 to 1860. 22. Constitutional experiments. 23. Galician autonomy. 24. The Great Economic Emigration. 25. First World War and Polish-Ukrainian conflict. 3. Administrative divisions. 31. Major cities and towns. 32. Other administrative entities. 4. Government. 41. Vice regents. 42. Political parties and public organizations. 5. Demographics. 6. Economy. 61. Industry. 62. Oil and natural gas industry. 7. Culture. 8. Flag of Galicia and Lodomeria. 9. Military. 10. See also. 11. Notes. 12. References. 13. Suggest reading. 14. External links. Ceremonial name. The name of the kingdom in its ceremonial form, known in English, as Kingdom of Galicia and Lodomeria and the Grand Duchy of Krakow with the duchies of Auschwitz and Zadar, existed in all languages spoken there including German, Königreich Galizien und Lodomerien mit dem Großherzogtum Krakau und den Herzogtümern Auschwitz und Zadar, Polish, Królestwo Galicji I Lodomery Wrazz Wielkom Siestwom Krakowskim I Siestwom Oświęcimia I Zatoru, Ukrainian, Korolivstivio Galicini ta Volodymyri z Velikim Nazistivom Krakiskim I Nazistvami Ovensima I Zatoru transliterated, Korolivstivio Halicini I Lodomyri z Velikim Knyazivstivom Krakiskim I Knyazivstiviami Ovensima I Zatoru, and Hungarian, Galicia s Lodomeria Karysaga Krako Nagy Herzegszegevel s Auschwitz s Zadar Herzegzegel. History. Main articles, Galicia Eastern Europe and Galicia Volhynia Wars. In 1772, Galicia was the largest part of the area annexed by the Habsburg monarchy in the first partition of Poland. As such, the Austrian region of Poland and what was later to become Ukraine was known as the Kingdom of Galicia and Lodomeria to underline the Hungarian claims to the country. However, after the third partition of Poland, a large portion of the ethnically Polish lands to the west, New or West Galicia, was also added to the province, which changed the geographical reference of the term Galicia. Lviv Lemberg served as capital of Austrian Galicia, which was dominated by the Polish aristocracy, despite the fact that the population of the eastern half of the province was mostly Ukrainian, or Ruthenian, as they were known at the time. In addition to the Polish aristocracy and gentry who inhabited almost all parts of Galicia, and the Ruthenians in the east, there existed a large Jewish population, also more heavily concentrated in the eastern parts of the province during the first decades of Austrian rule. Galicia was firmly governed from Vienna, and many significant reforms were carried out by a bureaucracy staffed largely by Germans and Germanized Czechs. The aristocracy was guaranteed its rights, but these rights were considerably circumscribed. The former serfs were no longer mere chattel, but became subjects of law and were granted certain personal freedoms, such as the right to marry without the lord's permission. Their labor obligations were defined and limited, and they could bypass the lords and appeal to the imperial courts for justice. The Eastern Rite Uniate Church, which primarily served the Ruthenians, was renamed the Greek Catholic Church to bring it onto a par with the Roman Catholic Church. It was given seminaries, and eventually, a metropolitan, although unpopular with the aristocracy, among the common folk, Polish and Ukrainian, Ruthenian alike. These reforms created a reservoir of goodwill toward the emperor which lasted almost to the end of Austrian rule. At the same time, however, the Austrian Empire extracted from Galicia considerable wealth and conscripted large numbers of the peasant population into its armed services. Chronology of political Political History 1815-1914. 1867 Dual Monarchy established 1868 Galician Resolution submitted to the Emperor Administration begins to pass into Polish hands 1873 Introduction of direct voting for Reichsrat elections 1896 Extension of the suffrage 1907 Universal suffrage introduced 1914 Enlargement and reorganization of the Diet from 1815 to 1860 In 1815, as a result of decisions of the Congress of Vienna, the Lublin area and surrounding regions most of the New or West Galicia were ceded by the Austrian Empire to Congress Poland Kingdom of Poland, which was ruled by the Tsar, and the Ternopil region, including the historical region of southern Podolia, was returned to the Austrian Empire by Russia, which had held it since 1809. The large city of Kraków and surrounding territory, formerly also part of New or West Galicia, became the semi-autonomous free city of Kraków under supervision of the three powers sharing rule over Poland, i.e., Austria, Russia and Prussia. Physical map of the Kingdom of Galicia and Lodomeria 1849-1918. The 1820s and 1830s were a period of bureaucratic rule overseen from Vienna. Most administrative positions were filled by German speakers, including German-speaking Czechs. Although some of their children were already becoming Polonized after the failure of the November insurrection in Russian Poland in 1830-31, in which a few thousand Galician volunteers participated, many Polish refugees arrived in Galicia. The latter 1830s were rife with Polish conspiratorial organizations whose work culminated in the unsuccessful Galician insurrection of 1846, which was easily put down by the Austrians with the help of a Galician peasantry that remained loyal to the emperor. The insurrection occurred in the western Polish-populated part of Galicia. Polish manorial gentry supported or were sympathetic to barely concealed plans for an uprising to establish an independent Polish state, but peasants on the manorial estates of western Galicia, reduced to misery by poor harvests, saw little advantage for themselves in a free Poland and seized the opportunity to rise against the institution of serfdom, killing many of the estate owners with the collapse of the uprising for a free Poland. The city of Kraków lost its semi-autonomy and was integrated into the Austrian Empire under the title of a Grand Duchy, and for practical purposes was made part of Galicia by the Austrian authorities in the same period. A sense of national awakening began to develop among the Ruthenians in the eastern part of Galicia. A circle of activists, primarily Greek Catholic seminarians, affected by the Romantic movement in Europe and the example of fellow Slavs elsewhere, especially in eastern Ukraine under the Russians, began to turn their attention to the common folk in their language in 1837, the so-called Ruthenian Triad led by Markian Shashkevich, published The Nymph of the Dniester, a collection of folk songs and other materials in the common Ruthenian tongue. Alarmed by such democratism, the Austrian authorities and the Greek Catholic Metropolitan banned the book in 1848. Revolutionary actions broke out in Vienna and other parts of the Austrian Empire in Lemberg, a Polish national council, and then later, a Ukrainian, or Ruthenian Supreme Council were formed even before Vienna had acted. The remnants of serfdom were abolished by the governor, Franz Stadion, in an attempt to thwart the revolutionaries. Moreover, Polish demands for Galician autonomy were countered by Ruthenian demands for national equality and for a partition of the province into an eastern, Ruthenian part, and a western, Polish part. Eventually, Lemberg was bombarded by imperial troops and the revolution put down completely. A decade of renewed absolutism followed, but to placate the Poles, Count Agnieszka Golachowski, a conservative representative of the eastern Galician aristocracy, the so-called Podolians, was appointed viceroy. He began to Polonize the local administration and managed to have Ruthenian ideas of partitioning the province shelved. He was unsuccessful, however, in forcing the Greek Catholic Church to shift to the use of the Western or Gregorian calendar, or among Ruthenians generally, to replace the Cyrillic alphabet with the Latin alphabet. Constitutional experiments. Galician Slaughter. Polish Rzeź Galicyjska by Jan Lewicki 1795-1871. See also, Diet of Galicia in 1859. Following Austro-Hungarian military defeat in Italy, the Empire entered a period of constitutional experiments in 1860. The Vienna government, influenced by Agnieszka Golachowski, issued its October Diploma, which envisioned a conservative federalization of the Empire, but a negative reaction in the German-speaking lands led to changes in government and the issuing of of the February patent, which watered down this decentralization nevertheless. By 1861, Galicia was granted a legislative assembly or Galicia Diet, although at first pro-Habsburg Ukrainian and Polish peasant representation was considerable in this body, about half the assembly, and the pressing social and Ukrainian questions were discussed. Administrative pressures limited the effectiveness of both peasant and Ukrainian representatives, and the Diet of Galicia became dominated by the Polish aristocracy and gentry, who favored further autonomy this same year. Disturbances broke out in Russian Poland and to some extent spilled over into Galicia. The same ceased to sit by 1863. Open revolt broke out in Russian Poland, and from 1864 to 1865 the Austro-Hungarian government declared a state of siege in Galicia, temporarily suspending civil liberties. The year 1865 brought a return to federal ideas along the lines suggested by Agnieszka Golachowska, and negotiations on autonomy between the Polish aristocracy and Vienna began once again. Meanwhile, the Ruthenians felt more and more abandoned by Vienna, and among the old Ruthenians grouped around the Greek Catholic Cathedral of St. George, there occurred a turn towards Russia. The more extreme supporters of this orientation came to be known as Russophiles. At the same time, influenced by the Ukrainian language poetry of the Eastern Ukrainian writer Taras Shevchenko, a Ukrainophile movement arose, which published literature in the Ukrainian, Ruthenian vernacular and eventually established a network of reading halls. Supporters of this orientation came to be known as populists, and later, simply as Ukrainians. Almost all Ruthenians, however, still hoped for national equality and for an administrative division of Galicia along ethnic lines. Galician autonomy. Galician Sejm Parliament in Lemberg, modern Lviv, in 1866, following the Battle of Sadova and the Austrian defeat in the Austro-Prussian War, the Austro-Hungarian Empire began to experience increased internal problems. In an effort to shore up support for the monarchy, Emperor Franz Joseph began negotiations for a compromise with the Magyar nobility to ensure their support. Some members of the government, such as the Austro-Hungarian Prime Minister Count Belcredi, advised the emperor to make a more comprehensive constitutional deal with all of the nationalities that would have created a federal structure. Belcredi worried that an accommodation with the Magyar interests would alienate the other nationalities. However, Franz Joseph was unable to ignore the power of the Magyar nobility, and they would not accept anything less than dualism between themselves and the traditional Austrian elites. Finally, after the so-called Ausgleich of February 1867, the Austrian Empire was reformed into a dualist Austria-Hungary, although the Polish and Czech plans for their parts of the monarchy to be included in the federal structure failed. A slow yet steady process of liberalization of Austrian rule in Galicia started. Representatives of the Polish aristocracy and intelligentsia addressed the emperor asking for greater autonomy for Galicia. Their demands were not accepted outright, but over the course of the next several years a number of significant concessions were made toward the establishment of Galician autonomy. From 1873, Galicia was de facto an autonomous province of Austria-Hungary, with Polish and, to a much lesser degree, Ukrainian or Ruthenian as official languages. The German Germanization had been halted and the censorship lifted as well. Galicia was subject to the Austrian part of the dual monarchy, but the Galician Sejm and provincial administration had extensive privileges and prerogatives, especially in education, culture, and local affairs. These changes were supported by many Polish intellectuals. In 1869, a group of young conservative publicists in Krakow, including Józef Szewski, Stanisław Tarnowski, Stanisław Kosmian and Ludwik Wodzicki, published a series of satirical pamphlets entitled Tika Stanzika Stanchik's Portfolio. Only 5 years after the tragic end of the January Uprising, the pamphlets ridiculed the idea of armed national uprisings and suggested compromise with Poland's enemies, especially the Austrian Empire, concentration on economic growth, and acceptance of the political concessions offered by Vienna. This political grouping came to be known as the Stanchiks or Krakow Conservatives, together with the Eastern Galician Conservatives. Conservative Polish landowners and aristocracy called the Podolians. They gained a political ascendancy in Galicia, which lasted to 1914. This shift in power from Vienna to the Polish landowning class was not welcomed by the Ruthenians, who became more sharply divided into Russophiles, who looked to Russia for salvation, and Ukrainians, who stressed their connections to the common people. Both Vienna and the Poles saw treason among the Russophiles, and a series of political trials eventually discredited them. Meanwhile, by 1890, an agreement was worked out out between the Poles and the populist Ruthenians or Ukrainians, which saw the partial Ukrainianization of the school system in eastern Galicia and other concessions to Ukrainian culture thereafter. The Ukrainian national movement spread rapidly among the Ruthenian peasantry and, despite repeated setbacks, by the early years of the 20th century this movement had almost completely replaced other Ruthenian groups as the main rival for power with the Poles. Throughout this period, the Ukrainians never gave up the traditional Ruthenian demands for national equality and for partition of the province into a western, Polish half, and an eastern, Ukrainian half, part of a series on Polish statehood. Poland, Kingdom of the Piasts, Kingdom of the Jagiellons, Polish-Lithuanian Commonwealth, Partitions of Poland, Kingdom of Galicia, Duchy of Warsaw, Kingdom of Poland, Congress, Poland, Free City of Krakow, Grand Duchy of Posen, Grand Duchy of Krakow, Regency, Kingdom of Poland, Second Polish Republic, Polish Underground State, People's Republic of Poland, Polish Government in Exile, Republic of Poland, Poland Portal VE, part of a series on the history of Ukraine, Prehistory, Tripolian, Kukuteni Culture, Yamna Culture, Catacomb Culture, Cimmeria, Torysa, Scythia, Bosporan Kingdom, Sarmatia, Zarubintsy Culture, Cherniakov Culture, Hunnic Empire, Early History, Early East Slavs, Anahuria, White Croatia, Rus Khaganate, Khazars, Kievan Rus, Galicia, Volhynia, Cumania, Mongol Invasion of Rus, Golden Horde, Principality of Moldavia, Grand Duchy of Lithuania, Crimean Khanate, Early Modern History, Cossacks, Polish-Lithuanian Commonwealth, Zaporozhian Host, Khmelnytsky Uprising, The Ruin, Cossack Hetmanate, Left Bank, Sloboda, Ukraine, Right Bank, Danube, Russian Empire, Little Russia, New Russia, Habsburg Monarchy, Kingdom of Galicia, Bukovina, Carpathian Ruthenia, Modern History, Ukraine during World War I, Ukraine after the Revolution, Ukrainian Civil War, Ukrainian People's Republic, West Ukrainian People's Republic, Ukrainian State Directorate of Ukraine, Ukrainian SSR, Communist Party of Ukraine, Holodomor, Ukraine in World War II, Organization of Ukrainian Nationalists, Chernobyl Cassette Scandal, Orange Revolution, Russia, Ukraine Gas Disputes, Euromaidan, Crimean Crisis. Topics by history. Name of Ukraine. Historical regions. Christianity in Ukraine. Ukraine Portal VE. The Great Economic Emigration, beginning in the 1880s. A mass emigration of the Galician peasantry occurred. The emigration started as a seasonal one to Germany, newly unified and economically dynamic, and then later became a transatlantic one with large-scale emigration to the United States, Brazil, and Canada, caused by the backward economic condition of Galicia, where rural poverty was widespread. The emigration began in the western, Polish-populated part of Galicia and quickly shifted east to the Ukrainian-inhabited parts. Poles, Ukrainians, Jews, and Germans all participated in this mass movement of countryfolk and villagers. Poles migrated principally to New England and the Midwestern states of the United States, but also to Brazil and elsewhere. Ruthenians, Ukrainians migrated to Brazil, Canada, and the United States, with a very intense emigration from southern Podolia to Western Canada, and Jews emigrated both directly to the New World and also indirectly via other parts of Austria-Hungary. A total of several hundred thousand people were involved in this great economic emigration, which grew steadily more intense until the outbreak of the First World War in 1914. The war put a temporary halt to the emigration, which never again reached the same proportions the great economic emigration, especially the emigration to Brazil. The Brazilian fever, as it was called at the time, was described in contemporary literary works by the Polish poet Maria Konopnicka, the Ukrainian writer Ivan Franko, and many others. Some states in south of Brazil have a large percentage of their population formed by direct descendants of these Ruthenians, Ukrainians immigrants. When it comes to the social relations, most especially between peasants and landlords, the area was the most backwards in the former Polish-Lithuanian Commonwealth for the entire 19th century. The majority of landlords viewed peasants as less than human. When the lot of the peasants under the Prussian partition was made better by laws, and in the Russian partition by the majority of the Polish landlords de facto abolishing serfdom in exchange for the peasants sending their children to free of charge secret with respect to the Polish language schools training them to be Poles, and nobility adopted all free peasants to prevent the Russian emperor from forcing them into serfdom, the Galician peasantry was always living at the verge of starvation. This led the Polish peasants to call the area Królestwo Głodu I Głodomierza, i.e. the Kingdom of Bareness and Starvation. At the same time as these emigrations in the 1890s, many Polish and Ukrainian liberals saw Galicia as a Galician Piedmont, both a Polish Piedmont and a Ukrainian Piedmont, because Italians had started their liberation from Austrian rule in the Italian Piedmont. These Ukrainian and Polish nationalists felt that the liberation of their two countries would begin in Galicia, despite nearly 750 50,000 persons emigrating across the Atlantic from 1880 to 1914, Galicia's population increased by 45% between 1869 and 1910. First World War and Polish-Ukrainian conflict. During the First World War, Galicia saw heavy fighting between the forces of Russia and the Central Powers. The Russian forces overran most of the region in 1914 after defeating the Austro-Hungarian army in a chaotic frontier battle in the opening months of the war. They were in turn pushed out in the spring and summer of 1915 by a combined German and Austro-Hungarian offensive siege of Pszemyszl in 1915. In 1918, Western Galicia became a part of the restored Republic of Poland, which absorbed the Lemko Rusyn Republic. The local Ukrainian population briefly declared the independence of Eastern Galicia as the West Ukrainian People's Republic. During the Polish-Soviet War, the Soviets tried to establish the puppet state of the Galician SSR in East Galicia, the government of which after a couple of months was liquidated. The fate of Galicia was settled by the Peace of Riga on March 18, 1921, attributing Galicia to the Second Polish Republic. Although never accepted as legitimate by some Ukrainians, it was internationally recognized with significant French support on May 15, 1923. The French support for Polish rule of ethnically Ukrainian Eastern Galicia and its oil resources in the Borislaw-Drohobych Basin were rewarded by Warsaw, allowing significant French investment to pour into the Polish oil industry. The Poles had convinced the French that since less than 25% of the ethnic Ukrainians were literate before the Great War and Ukrainians were novices in governing themselves, only the Poles, not the Ukrainians, would be able to administer Eastern Galicia and its precious oil assets. The Ukrainians of the former Eastern Galicia and the neighboring province of Volhynia made up about 12% of the Second Polish Republic population, and were its largest minority. As Polish government policies were unfriendly towards minorities, tensions between the Polish government and the Ukrainian population grew, eventually giving the rise to the militant underground organization of Ukrainian Nationalists' administrative divisions. Main article, subdivisions of Galicia. Soon the newly acquired Polish territories, see First Partition of Poland, which were known as Kreis Voivodeship in Poland, were restructured in November 1773 into 59 Kreisdistrikties land districts. While Kreises were abolished, some former voivodeships were incorporated completely, while most of them only partially. Among them were the former voivodeships of Belz, Red Ruthenian, Krakow, Lublin, Sandomierz, and Podolia. Also during the Russo-Turkish War in 1769, the northwestern territory of Moldavia, renamed Bukovina, was occupied by the Russian Empire, which ceded it in 1774 to the Austrian Empire as a token of appreciation. Major cities and towns administrative division. The kingdom was split into numerous counties. Powiat, which in 1914 were about 75, besides Lwów being the capital of the kingdom. Krakow was considered as the unofficial capital of the western part of Galicia and the second most important city in the region. Kingdom of Galicia, administrative, 1914. Belz Polish, Belz, Yiddish, Belz Berezani Polish, Brzezani Beach German, Bych, Ukrainian, Bek Bech Bochnia German, Salzburg. Borislav Polish, Borislav Brody Yiddish, Broad Busk Bukok Polish, Buchach Chorkiv Polish, Zorkow Krzyżanow Dukla Ukrainian, Dukla Duklia Drohobych Polish, Drohobych Gorlice Ukrainian, Gorlicei Horlitzi, German, Gorlitz Halich Polish, Halitz, German, Halich, Yiddish, Galitz Huzhidin Jaroslaw German, Jaroslaw, Ukrainian, Arislav Yaroslav Jaslow German, Jasl Kalush Polish, Kalush Kolomia German, Kolomia, Polish, Kolomia, Romanian, Kolomia, Yiddish, Kolome Kozowa Polish, Kozowa Krakow German, Krakow, Yiddish, Kruk Krasno German, Krasin, Ukrainian, Korozno Korozno. Lesko Ukrainian, Lisko Lisko, Yiddish, Linsk Lizajisk German, Lyschansk, Yiddish, Lijunsk Limanowa German, Ilmenau Lviv German, Lemberg, Polish, Lwow, Yiddish, Lemberik Lankit German, Lanchit Makliniak Myslenis German, Myślenets Nadwrna Polish, Nadwrna Nawi Sanch German, Noi Sandes, Yiddish, Zanzo Szwęcim German, Auschwitz, Yiddish, Oshpetsin Paramyślini Polish, Szemyslani Pszemyszl Ukrainian, Paramyzl Paramyszl Pidhytsi Polish, Podhe Rawa Ruska Polish, Rawa Ruska, Yiddish, Rave Rahatin Rimano German, Rymanshow Zeshov Yiddish, Resha, Ukrainian, Ryashiv, German, Rykshov Sambir Polish, Sambir. Sanik Ukrainian, Sanik Sianik, Yiddish, Sanik, Hungarian, Sanik Stanislavy Polish, Stanislavov, German, Stanislav, Yiddish, Stanislav, now, Ivano Frankisk Tarabavlia Polish, Trembola Ternopol Polish, Tarnopol Tarno Ukrainian, Tarnov Tarnov, German, Tarno Tomazow Lubelski Ukrainian, Tomaszew Lyublinski Truskovets Polish, Truskovic Wielicka German, Grosols Zolicheki Polish, Zalizika Zader German, Neuenstadt and Derschau Zolichev Polish, Zalazow, Yiddish, Zalatchev Zavkwa Polish, Zoku Zywik Ukrainian, Zivik Zihivets, German, Sabish. Other administrative entities: West Galicia, part of the kingdom from 1795 to 1809, until 1803 a separate administrative unit Biala Podlaska. Chelm Josefa Kielce Konski Krakow Lublin Lukow at Radzin Podlaski Minsk at Wyazona Radom Sandomirs, from 1798 at Opato Siedlce territory of Bukovina part of the kingdom from 1775 to 1849 after 1849, Duchy of Bukovina Free City of Krakow Condominium with Prussia and Russia from 1815 to 1846 part of the kingdom since 1846 government after the partition of Poland the region was government by an appointed governor, later a vice-regent during the war time the office of vice-regent was supplemented by a military governor in 1861 a regional assembly was established, the same of the land, which initially due to lack of adequate administrative building was located in the building of the Skarbek Theatre until 1890 vice-regents the vice-regency office in Lemberg modern Lviv, since 1880 list of vice-regents since 1900, see also, list of Galician rulers Count Leon Pilinski March 31, 1898 to June 1903 Count Andrei Potocki June 8, 1903 to April 12, 1908 Count Michal Babrzynski April 28, 1908 to May 14, 1913 Witold Korotowski May 14, 1913 to August 20, 1915 Russian occupation September 1914, 1915 Hermann von Collard August 1915 to April 8, 1916 Baron Erich von Diller April 1916 to March 1917 exiled due to Russian occupation 1916 July 26, 1917 Count Karl Georg Hein 1917 November 1, 1918, in fact subordinate to the Regency Council and its General Commissar Prince Witold Leon Czartoryski instead of the Austrian Crown political parties and public organizations. Political Chief Ruthenian Council May 2, 1848-1851, headed by Gregory Yahimovich and later by Mikhailo Kazemsky it consisted of 30 members Ruthenian Council Lviv 1870-1814 Ruthenian Congress May 23, 1848 was an oppositional political formation to the Chief Ruthenian Council to which belong such personalities as Ivan Vahilovich, Julian Lorivskij, Leon Sapieha, and others Ukrainian National Democratic Party 1899-1919 was created in place of the People's Council 1885-1899, eventually becoming part of the Ukrainian National Democratic Alliance Undo Ukrainian Radical Party 1890-1939 Christian Social Party 1896-1930, until 1911 was called as Catholic Ruthenian People's Union, in 1930 it split when some members joined Undo, while others created Ukrainian Catholic People's Party Ukrainian Social Democratic Party 1899-1939, was created by some members of the Ukrainian Radical Party and in 1924 partially merged with Communist Party of Western Ukraine 1919-1938 Ukrainian General Council 1914-1916, initially as the Chief Ukrainian Council, was a national political bloc of most of the Ukrainian parties it laid foundation for creating the Ukrainian state in the West Ukraine Public Ukrainian Forum Besida until 1928 Ruthenian Forum 1861-1939, a forum-type association created by Julian Lorivskij based on the Lviv Intelligentsia Circle, Young Rus the organization established its own Ukrainian-based professional theater 1864-1924 Prosvita 1868 present Shevchenko Scientific Society 1873 present Ruthenian Triad 1833-1843, literary organization discontinued after the death of Markian Shashkovich Academic Society Ramada 1882-1921, until 1896 as Brotherhood Academical Circle 1874-1877 Sokol and Sokol Sport Organization created in light of the European Sokol Movement Sich and Plast Lu, a Fireman Society Riflemen's Association demographics in 1773, Galicia had about 26 million inhabitants in 280 cities and markets and approximately 5,500. villages. There were nearly 19,000 noble families with 95,000 members, about 3% of the population. The non-free accounted for 186 million, more than 70% of the population. A small number were full farmers, but by far the overwhelming number, 84%, had only smallholdings or no possessions. People of East Galicia. No country of the Austrian monarchy had such a varied ethnic mix as Galicia: Poles, Ruthenians, Germans, Galician Germans, Armenians, Jews, Hungarians, Romani people, Lipowaner, etc. The Poles were mainly in the west, with the Ruthenians predominant in the eastern region, Ruthenia. The Jews of Galicia had immigrated in the Middle Ages from Germany and mostly spoke Yiddish as their first language. German-speaking people were more commonly referred to by the region of Germany where they originated, e.g., Saxons or Swabians, with inhabitants who had a clear difference in language, such as with the Saxons or the Roma. Identification was less problematic, but widespread multilingualness blurred the borders again. It is, however, possible to make a clear distinction in religious denominations. The majority of the Poles were Latin Catholics, while the Ruthenians were mostly Greek Catholics. The Jews, who represented the third largest religious group, were mostly Orthodox in their religious observance. The average life expectancy was 27 years for men and 285 years for women, as compared to 33 and 37 in Bohemia, 39 and 41 in France, and 40 and 42 in England. Also, the quality of life was much lower. The yearly consumption of meat did not exceed 10.109% Protestant, 37,144.05% Other, 5,454.00% Total, 8,025,675 Economy. Galicia was economically the least developed part of Austria and received considerable transfer payments from the Vienna government. Its level of development was comparable to or higher than that of Russia and the Balkans, but well behind Western Europe. The first detailed description of the economic situation of the region was prepared by Stanisław Szczepanowski, 1846-1900, a Polish lawyer, economist and chemist who in 1873 published the first version of his report titled Nedza Galicijska w Cyfrach, the Galician poverty in numbers, based on his own experience as a worker in the India office, as well as his work on development of the oil industry in the region of Borislaw and the official census data. Published by the Austro-Hungarian government, he described Galicia as one of the poorest regions in Europe. Statistics indicate the Galicia and Lodomeria was poorer than areas west of it. The average income per capita did not exceed 53 Rhine guilders RG, as compared to 91 RG in the Kingdom of Poland, 100 in Hungary and more than 450 RG in England at that time. Also, the taxes were relatively high and equal to 9 Rhine guilders a year, ca 17% of yearly income, as compared to 5% in Prussia and 10% in England. Also, the percentage of people with higher income was much lower than in other parts of the monarchy in Europe. The luxury tax, paid by people whose yearly income exceeded 600 RG, was paid by 8 people in every 1,000 inhabitants, as compared to 28 in Bohemia and 99 in Lower Austria. Despite high taxation, the national debt of the Galician government exceeded 300 million RG at all times, that is approximately 60 RG per capita. All in all, the region was used by the Austro-Hungarian government mostly as a reservoir of cheap workforce and recruits for the army, as well as a buffer zone against Russia. It was not until early in the 20th century that heavy industry started to be developed, which would be comparable to much of Russia and the Balkans. Even then, it was mostly connected to war production. The biggest state investments in the region were the railways and the fortresses in Pšemyšl, Krakow and other cities. Industrial development was mostly connected to the private oil industry started by Ignacy Kosovic and to the Wieliczka salt mines. Operational since at least the Middle Ages. Industry in 1880. Industry in Galicia was at a low level in 1857. Galicia had 102,189 persons, or 22% of the population, worked in industry. By 1870, that number had risen to 179,626, or 33% of the population. Oil and natural gas industry. See also the Petroleum Trail rail lines of Galicia before 1897 near Drohobyč and Borislaw in Galicia. Significant oil reserves were discovered and developed during the mid-19th and early 20th centuries. The first European attempt to drill for oil was in Babrka in western Galicia in 1854. By 1867, a well at Klecheny, in western Galicia, was drilled using steam to about 200 metres. On December 31, 1872, a railway line linking Borislaw, now Borislaw, with the nearby city of Drohobyč, now Drohobyč, was opened. American John Simon Bergheim and Canadian William Henry McGarvey came to Galicia in 1882. In 1883, their company, McGarvey and Bergheim, bored holes of 700 to 1,000 meters and found large oil deposits. In 1885, they renamed their oil developing enterprise the Galician Carpathian Petroleum Company, German, Galizische Karpathische Petroleum Action Gesellschaft, headquartered in Vienna, with McGarvey as the chief administrator and Bergheim as field engineer, and built a huge refinery at Mariampol near Gorlice, in the southeast corner of Galicia, considered the biggest, most efficient enterprise in Austro-Hungary. Mariampol was built in 6 months and employed 1,000 men subsequently. Investors from Britain, Belgium, and Germany established companies to develop the oil and natural gas industries in Galicia. This influx of capital caused the number of petroleum enterprises to shrink from 900 to 484 by 1884, and to 285 companies manned by 3,700 workers by 1890. However, the number of oil refineries increased from 31 in 1880 to 54 in 1904. By 1904, there were 30 boreholes in Borislaw of over 1,000 meters. Production increased by 50% between 1905 and 1906, and then trebled between 1906 and 1909 because of unexpected discoveries of vast oil reserves, of which many were gushers. By 1909, production reached its peak at 2,076,000 tons, or 4% of worldwide production, often called the Polish Baku. The oil fields of Borislaw and nearby Tustanovice accounted for over 90% of the national oil output of the Austria-Hungary Empire. From 500 residents in the 1860s, Borislaw had swollen to 12,000 by 1898. In 1909, Pullman, with headquarters in Lviv, was established for the extraction and distribution of natural gas. At the turn of the century, Galicia was ranked 4th in the world as an oil producer. This significant increase in oil production also caused a slump in oil prices. A very rapid decrease in oil production in Galicia occurred just before the Balkans conflicts. Galicia was the Central Powers' only major domestic source of oil during the Great War. Culture newspapers, Gazette de Leopold 1776, Slovo closed in 1876 due to M's Ukazi weekly, Zoria Halicka first issue on May 15, 1848, Flag of Galicia and Lodomeria until 1849. Galicia and Lodomeria constituted a single province with Bukovina and used the blue-red flag consisting of two horizontal stripes. The upper one was blue, the lower one was red. In 1849, when Bukovina was given an independent status from that of Galicia Lodomeria, it kept the blue-red flag, while Galicia was given a new flag consisting of three horizontal stripes, blue, red and yellow. This flag had remained in use until 1890, when Galicia Lodomeria received a new flag consisting of two horizontal stripes, red and white. This flag remained in use until the dissolution of the Kingdom of Galicia Lodomeria in 1918 and is displayed in Strohl's Österreichisch-Ungarisch Wappenroll 1898 flag of Galicia, 1772-1800 Flag of Galicia, 1800-1849 References. Jan Miller, Korigui I Flagi Polski, Instytut Wydawniczy Nasza Kasegarnia, Warsaw 1962, Hugo Strohl, Österreichisch-Ungarisch Wappenroll, Vienna 1898. Military Main Article, Austro-Hungarian Army. The kingdom was divided into three major military districts centered in Kraków, Lwow, and Pashemyshl. Local military used a specialized language for communication known as Army Slav. One of the major army units was the 1st Army, consisting of 1st Kraków, 5th Pressburg, and 10th Pashemyshl Corps selected units. 1914, command language German. 8 out of 11 Lancer regiments were located in Galicia. See Ulan. The 13th Galicia Lancer Regiment at Battle of Custoza 1866. 1st Galicia Lancer Regiment of Ritter von Brudermann 85% Poles. Regimental language Polish. 2nd Galicia Lancer Regiment of 1st zu Schwarzenberg 84% Poles. Regimental language Polish. 3rd Galicia Lancer Regiment of Archduke Karl 69% Poles, 26% Ukrainians. Regimental language Polish. 4th Galicia Lancer Regiment Kaiser 65% Ukrainians, 29% Poles. Regimental language Polish and Ukrainian. 6th Galicia Lancer Regiment of Kaiser Joseph II 52% Poles, 40% Ukrainians. Regimental language Polish and Ukrainian. 7th Galicia Lancer Regiment of Archduke Franz Ferdinand 72% Ukrainians, 22% Poles. Regimental language Ukrainian. 8th Galicia Lancer Regiment of Count Auersperg 80% Poles. Regimental language Polish. 13th Galicia Lancer Regiment of Eduard von Bohm-Ermoli 55% Ukrainians, 42% Poles Regimental language Polish and Ukrainian 1st Army Lancer Regiment 65% Ukrainians, 30% Poles 3rd Army Lancer Regiment 69% Poles, 26% Ukrainians 4th Army Lancer Regiment 85% Poles 1 Dragoon Regiment 9th Galicia Bukowina Dragoon Regiment of Archduke Albrecht 50% Romanians, 29% Ukrainians Regimental language Romanian and Ukrainian Shako of Polish National Guard in Lviv in 1848 Rudolf Barracks in Krakow 10 Infantry Regiments. 16th Army Infantry Regiment Krakow 82% Poles 17th Army Infantry Regiment Rzeszów 97% Poles 18th Army Infantry Regiment Pshemyszl 47% Ukrainians 43% Poles 19th Army Infantry Regiment Lemberg 59% Ukrainians 31% Poles 20th Army Infantry Regiment Stanislaw 72% Ukrainians 32nd Army Infantry Regiment 91% Poles Tarno 33rd Army Infantry Regiment 73% Ukrainians, Stry 34th Army Infantry Regiment 75% Poles, Jaroslaw 35th Army Infantry Regiment 68% Ukrainians, 25% Poles, Zolichev 36th Army Infantry Regiment 70% Ukrainians, 21% Poles, Kolomeya 2 Artillery Divisions 43rd Field Artillery Division 55% Ukrainians, 25% Poles, Lemberg 45th Field Artillery Division 60% Ukrainians, 25% Poles, Pshemyszl 5 Feldjäger Battalions Military Police 4th Galicia Feldjäger Battalion 77% Poles, Braunau M in Rzeszów District 12th Bohemia Feldjäger Battalion 67% Czech, 32% German, Cavalry's Krakow District 14th Feldjäger Battalion 47% Ukrainians, 43% Poles, Metzolombardo Pshemyszl District 18th Feldjäger Battalion 59% Ukrainians, 31% Poles, Trient Lviv District.